of you. When we organize this one day again, we know that there's a time constraint, all of us has to leave. I think both of them has to leave by 4:30. So we have exactly 2.5 hours. So what we told the organizers is, give all the statements in writing, and we will invite only some of them to highlight whatever they have said. The rest of the writing will take into account as part of the record. So, in the first, we have statements of 5 witnesses, but we will be hearing only 2. The others should not feel bad because their statement in writing is available with us. So, that will also form part of the record. So, we will call Firas Soni first, and later Dr. K.Y. Ratna in the first part of the hearing. And thereafter, we will be hearing Amita Nandas. And finally, when it comes to the older reports, we will have a choice of who should be heard. First, we call Ms. Firas Soni, Research Scholar, Department of Social.
Just a small announcement before we begin. Human Rights Forum has also given an essay written by Bhargav Pal on the subject, and he is handed it off to the commission, and they would like us to announce it over here.
Talk about what has happened from 22nd, but also very quickly give a small review of what had been happening before also, in brief. I joined the university in 2015 in the MPhil course, and when I joined around August, there were protests going on against police patrolling inside campus. Even before that, before me joining also, the previous semester, the protests against police entry inside campus were going on. And lot of, basically, Cyberabad police vehicle would patrol in the campus, and there was a lot of moral policing from the part of the police. And generally, the presence of police on campus was intimidating to students. So we were protesting about that, and we had approached the administration several times about it, etc. One of the incidents that happened at that time was a Cyberabad police commissioner or somebody from the police was invited in a freshers orientation program where a pamphlet kind of a thing was given out, handed out to the freshers in that program, which said that anti-national activities even in cyberspace etc. will not be tolerated, and you have to be I think that copy of that pamphlet can be available, but basically it had this word called anti-national activities will not be tolerated, social media posts will be are under surveillance kind of a
that pamphlets were distributed by whom?
By the they were issued in the name of the police, the Cyberabad police.
Official,
and they were distributed inside university's freshers program. Freshers orientation program. So we, like, while on one hand the students are protesting or asking accountability from the administration as to why police is entering inside the campus, at the same time we saw that administration is inviting the same police and handing out these pamphlets in the same format of that pamphlet with the same color codes and the exactly same design. We had another thing that was issued by the administration, which was a new student's code of conduct, hostel code of conduct. And the earlier hostel code of conduct was fine, I mean it had its own problems, but it was operating fine. This new hostel code of conduct said that there can be raids conducted into your hostel rooms at any time, and entry of women into boys' hostel is not allowed, and several things like that. So, I mean, both these things came at the same time, and we could see that they are printed basically by the administration only or whatever, but that collusion between police and administration was very visible and very violent for us to experience. So, we had a UGBM, University General Body meeting by the Students' Union, and where unanimously all the students passed a resolution saying that we will not tolerate police entry inside campus. It was the same time where one of our faculty's houses were also raided by the administration, and the your teachers, UHTA had been protesting about it and seeking accountability on that part as well. So all these things were going on at that time, and at that time also we go in front of the administration in a protest. What happens in a protest is you go and to the administration block and you have the registrar, the vice chancellor, everybody noticing you. And many times we saw that the campus security taking photographs and using video recordings, even the police and the campus security. So what we have been experiencing since the beginning is one thing is a surveillance, very open kind of a surveillance. Another thing, we feel targeted, that certain people get noticed. So anybody who is more vocal will get noticed, and I don't think it will be wrong to say that Rohit and the people who have been who were selected to give the punishment were also selected because of them being more vocal and them being more active and seeking. During my admissions when I had come to the university, it was these people who had helped me with a lot of issues related to getting access to the ad block and asking. I was in the waiting list, so all those formalities. So, So once we submitted the resolutions of our UGBM to the administration, another UGC circular came up saying, recommending that there will be a police post in every university. So it was a recommendation. So the administration again stalled our, they did not follow through the process of taking the resolution of the students to the police and saying that you cannot come inside campus because of the UGC circular. After that, the suspension and all these things started. I think people have already spoken about it. So we participated in it as part of larger students' protest. We formed a joint action committee where all the student organizations in campus came together and decided that we will plan out how the protests go on, especially because the students who were suspended were also not allowed to participate in any kind of protest as a part of their suspension. So that was one thing. I want to highlight one fact that setting up such a, the way the students have protested is like setting up of even a joint action committee by students etc. is a reflects that how democratically or how politically we imagine how protests in campus or how questions should be raised to the administration. It's a reflection of our own understanding of politics and of democracy, democratic values. So, like many things which do not get addressed institutionally get addressed by student political formations or political organizations inside campus which cannot be accommodated institutionally. We cannot have institutional mechanisms for many things. For example, the feeling of dignity in a person cannot come through institutional mechanisms but will come through participating in a student political organization or like many such things. So we feel that the administration throughout has also criminalized student political action in campus, has made attempts to target students who engage in those things, and has punished, as we see, and it has culminated into somebody's death as well. There were constantly we used to get this thing from the administration that please do not paste posters in campus everywhere. It makes the campus look ugly. What will outside image of the university, etc. But when you look at the posters, they are extremely profound and extremely engaged in such deep discussions politically. Once the suspension thing came and we all started protesting, we were participating regularly in the thing along with like attending classes or and all that. After Rohit's death, then we called for a university, a 10-day university strike, which so that we made sure that this is not a normal campus, this is not a normal situation, and everybody has to come out and ask justice for Rohit, and that strike happened. On the 22nd, I reached the VC. We heard that Parav has come back to campus, and I reached the VC's lodge at around 12 o'clock. After reaching the VC's lodge, like I saw many people, students, all of my friends, and everybody protesting there. And then we
we all assembled behind the lodge, behind the lawns in the lodge, and some people were also standing in the front just to see what is going on with the security and the police. So we were raising slogans and all that on the lawns, and the police and the media were there. Media was already there when we entered. We already saw members of non-teaching staff. We saw member ABVP students, students from life science department. A few faculty were also present there inside the VC's lodge, and they were like moving the curtain and watching us from inside what is going on, those kind of things. We heard that it is an executive council meeting or like some meeting which is going on, and therefore his lodge was not operating as a private residence but as an administrative office. So we felt rightfully there should not be a problem if we stage a protest there, because that is the site, I mean, where he is operating as the vice chancellor. So we were, the protest continued. The demand of our protest was that arrest of Professor Appara should happen immediately, because he is charged under the case. And so around, I think after 2:30 or sometime, the police started giving us warnings saying that you are trespassing in a private space, and you should move out immediately, and you are creating a law and order situation, whereas we were just sitting and raising slogans and demanding that the same police which is protecting him should arrest him. After some time, they said that we are going to now evict you from this thing. So they charged towards us. We all decided that we will just lie down and we will not move and let them drag us. I mean, because we are protesting democratically. So we laid down, we were just lying down and sitting, and then they started dragging. One of the girl students, she was being dragged by, there were only three female constables and two police inspectors, like not constables. And they did not have any lathis with them. One of the police women was holding a stick which was a part of a furniture which had broken. So that stick had all those, it was not a lathi that you are supposed to use. I did not see her using it, but she was holding it and carrying it everywhere. And once this rabali, she was being dragged by three or four women, and her clothes were like raised up and all those, it was a horrible thing. So two of me and two of my friends, we went towards her and tried to rescue her from that situation. Then, like when we turned back, they were starting to drag other people. We went and we also stayed there, and we tried to prevent the male police from hitting the male students. Once they dragged us out of the VC lodge, so they did not drag us out of the main gate, but out the back, from the back gate. The back gate opens into a jungle, like ideally they should have taken us out of the main gate, but they so now after evicting us from the lodge premises, their work should be done, because the purpose was to evict the students from that compound. But just as they dragged us outside, while dragging us from there, they were not really using lathis. They were kicking and they were humiliating women by raising their clothes, etc. But they were not using lathis. As soon as we got outside of the gate, the police started lathi charging, and a very shocking thing, because now that you have evicted us, why do you need to lathi charge us? And I saw them dragging a few men, students back, and then hit them or circle them and then kick them, and deliberately targeting students. They took away phones and smashed the phones. They took away phones into their own custody as well, people who were trying to click pictures. And some of the girls, we made a line in front of the men who were getting beaten up, so that the male police should not target them. At that time, the male police, they put their lathis on our chest and pushed us back. So that is one thing. One of my friends got hit on her backside, and that was absolutely unnecessary, because students were dispersing. It was not that there was any kind of a reaction. So that happened, and after that they chased us for another kilometer and a half. The students who were just standing outside their department also got dragged into the thing. Somebody was playing cricket, he also got dragged into, like, police met him and all that, because he was shooting. And So after all this happened on the 22nd, the police were still on campus. Our friends were picked up and detained. We did not know where they have been taken away or how many have been taken away, etc. That kind of a confusion and shock and thing was happening. After that, the next day or the few days till that time, when we were trying to understand who has been picked up, etc., FIR came. One FIR after another started surfacing. And we had, we saw that the police has launched an FIR and our own administration, our dear registrar has filed cases against us. And so many students have been named. And when we look at the list, we feel that it is a targeting of students. It's not a list that is just, you know, somebody who was there or there is some evidence. It's a clear, it's a very prepared list. It's not a list that suddenly, who were there and they were picked up. So it's a thought of list. And these things were happening. We were trying to figure out who. So I am one of the, along with four other women, I am one of the people named in the FIRs with the, in bracket it says yet to be arrested. And we were confused about that term as well. What does yet to be arrested mean? So the next day, some lawyers came from Bombay to meet us. We were immensely terrorized because for one thing, you don't know what has happened to the people who are picked up and your name is also there in the FIR. And some lawyers came to Bombay from Bombay, and even though we were terrified of going near our own campus security or the police, some of us went to the main gate to get them inside. But they were not letting these people enter, and they showed their I cards, they showed that they are lawyers, etc., but they were not being allowed inside. In spite of fighting a lot, they were not being allowed inside. Now they were like younger looking, so we were able to sneak them in as students eventually, because we had to talk to them to understand what is going on. For a month, I have not walked to my hostel alone at night because I feel scared, because police is patrolling inside campus, and I have not been able to go to my own hostel alone in my own campus. Stayed alone. We always stayed in groups, and we did not go to our rooms because we were afraid that we will get picked up, or how that picking up will happen itself was such a confused thing that we did not know what to do, and legal help was being denied. There was no sense of clarity about what is going on. For some time we had to stay in one or two nights I slept in a faculty's house also because of so much fear of what is happening, and the fear is still there. There was one time when they said that the police is going to come and remove the velivada. On the next day or two days after that, they had a lot of police had come to campus, much more than that had come before, and we heard that more female police force is being employed, because that time they were short on women police, and for them women students created a lot of nuisance. And the thing was that they will again pick up students. I think that was the same time when Uday Bhanu was also beaten up, when they had cut off our food and messes and internet and everything, and the students were preparing food outside, and Uday was beaten up and dragged by the police. I think he will speak about that. Yeah, so fine. So I just want to focus on the fact that how administration and police is targeting students and creating an atmosphere of fear, and this fear is a sign of their guilt, is what we, how we understand.
Quick questions to you. Student policy politics on the campus is party-based politics?
There are student organizations inside campus.
No, I say political party-based politics.
Well, I don't know.
You don't know.
ASA for Ambedkarite Students Association.
Like ABUP is a political party.
We have SFI on campus, but we have also many other student political formations which are not affiliated to
which is the dominant one?
Congress is there.
Which is the dominant one? Which party for students UP is dominant? ABUP or SFI or ASF or Ambedkar's?
There is, I mean,
Definitely, for example, Ambedkar Right Students Association is a big organization in terms of its strength, which is not affiliated to any political party outside. SFI is also an organization which is big in number.
Now, the Students Union, who are they in majority? In?
This year, SFI has won.
Who is the president of the Students Union?
Yes, it is there. He has spoken about blockade and this lathi charge and all that. It's there.
No, I just wanted to know his name.
Yes. Zuhail KP.
Okay.
He was there in the morning and he continued.
Okay, wait, Ratna. Thank you.